Picture this. You're sitting on the beach when you get a call from your boss letting you know that that app you built is broken. While he's busy tallying up the total losses to the business from this, you jump on your phone to pull up a recording, realizing the problem and having single-handedly saved the business from collapse with just a few minutes of work, you sit back in your chair to savor that well-deserved drink. The good news is you don't have to build this feature from scratch. In fact, I'll show you how to get started with Microsoft Clarity in 10 minutes or less, or this video is free. Towards the end, I'll show you how to supercharge your analytics with advanced features such as custom events and tags. Still not convinced? What if I told you that this thing comes for the low, low price of free? Okay, let's go. Clarity is Microsoft's solution for capturing key events in your applications. With Clarity, you can capture and analyze user behavior no matter where it happens in your app. Microsoft Clarity gives you the power to review and act on user data in real time so you can improve your users' experiences. By combining Microsoft Clarity with the Power Platform, you unlock the power of instant replay analytics to understand your users' behavior like never before. To get started, visit the Microsoft Clarity homepage by going to clarity.microsoft.com, click on the Get Started button, and sign in with an account of your choice. Give your project a name, a URL, and an industry, then click Add New Project. On your new Clarity project dashboard, select View All Platforms, then SharePoint, and then the Copy Project ID button. Keep this project ID somewhere safe, as we'll need it shortly. Now let's dive over to the GitHub repo to download the necessary solution file. Select the most recent release from the Releases pane, and then download the Manage solution. Before we can actually use this solution, we're going to want to make sure that the Power Apps component framework is enabled in our selected environment. Head on over to the Power Platform Admin Center, select Manage from the left navigation, then find the environment you're going to be working in. Expand the menu on the environment and select Settings to navigate to this environment's settings page. Here you'll want to expand the Products section and select Features to be taken to the Feature page. Scroll down to find the Power Apps Component Framework for Canvas App feature, turn it on to enable it, and select Save. With the solution file in hand, let's go ahead and import it into our Power Platform environment. From the Power Apps Maker portal, select Solutions from the left navigation, then select Import from the command bar. Navigate to and select the Manage Solution file we downloaded earlier. While it's importing, now's about as good a time as any to finish knitting that sweater you've been working on. Once it's imported, you can navigate to the Manage Solutions tab and verify that the Microsoft Clarity solution has been imported successfully. Now it's finally time to take your Power App to the next level with our PCF integration. Open your application in the Power App Studio and select the Insert icon on the left. Select the Get More Components icon to open the Import Components pane. Select the Code tab along the top of this pane. If you don't see code as an option, go back to earlier in this video where we saw how to enable the use of Power Apps Component Framework components. From here, select our Microsoft Clarity component and then import. Expand the Code Components section in the Insert pane and add our newly imported Microsoft Clarity component to the canvas. Now let's go into its properties to finish setting it up. First things first, let's give our component a proper name. Next, go grab that Clarity project ID we copied earlier and use it as the value for the Clarity project ID property. For the consent granted property, you can either set it to true or, if you don't like the idea of recording your Power Apps Studio sessions, you can instead set it to a formula that is true only if the current session is not in the studio. That's all we need to begin capturing sessions to our Clarity project, so now's the time to save and publish our app. Let's open both our Microsoft Clarity project and the Power App we just published. Refreshing our Microsoft Clarity project dashboard, we can see that we have a live user session happening right now. Clicking the video icon will take us straight to the current live sessions, where we can see our active app in the web player. And as you can see, the actions we're taking in our current Power App session are recorded in Microsoft Clarity and as close to real time as possible. Beyond just viewing real time sessions, Microsoft Clarity enables us to gain deep insights into user interactions on our application, to understand areas where users may be experiencing frustration or confusion. The platform provides detailed analytics on user demographics and behavior patterns, and smart events to highlight significant actions we define in the context of our app. Moreover, Clarity lets us replay user sessions through recordings to see exactly how users navigate through our application. This helps us pinpoint specific areas where users encounter problems, abandon processes, or get stuck. By watching these recordings, we gain a first-hand understanding of user experiences, validating our insights with visual evidence. Better still, Copilot in Microsoft Clarity gives us the ability to quickly summarize a user session or group of sessions with ease. This powerful combination of real-time analytics and session replays enables us to make more informed decisions to enhance user engagement, improve functionality, and ultimately drive better results for our applications. Finally, and as promised, let's go back into our app to quickly learn how to apply our own custom smart events and session tags. Both of these are displayed in various areas of your Clarity project, such as the Recordings and Details pane, and both can be used as filters to narrow down session recordings to the exact ones you're looking for. The best part? Creating them is as simple as updating a variable. To apply a smart event, simply update the Clarity event context variable with the message of your choosing. You can have as little or as many smart events as you'd like per session, and they do not need to be uniquely named. You can create smart events for errors, submissions, or anything else you might need. Similarly, to apply custom tags to your sessions, you'll want to collect items to the Clarity Session Tags collection as shown. You can think of tags as additional metadata you can apply to a given recording, which means you generally only apply a given tag once per app session. And that's it. With these steps, you're now fully equipped to get started with Microsoft Clarity in your Power Apps. So go ahead, start tagging your sessions, setting up smart events, and gaining incredible visibility into how users are interacting with your app. Let me know what you think, and be sure to drop your comments below. Until then, happy making.